माई सेल्फ कीर्तिपाल फ्रॉम मानिकलाल मेहता MPS वेलकम्स यू टू ऑनलाइन लर्निंग क्लास ऑफ ब्रिन मुंबई म्युनिसिपल कॉरपोरेशन. स्टे होम स्टे सेफ. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न इंग्लिश सब्जेक्ट. द नेम ऑफ आर टुडेज लेसन इज 4.4 अ मैट टी पार्टी. अ मैट टी पार्टी इट इज अ स्मॉल पार्ट और यू कैन से एन एपिसोड of novel Alice in Wonderland. Alice in Wonderland, students, it is a novel, and a mad tea party, it is a small episode of it. Like on cartoon networks, you watch many cartoons, so that cartoons, it is divided into episodes, you watch episodes of it. In the same way, a mad tea party, it is an episode of a novel Alice in Wonderland. Alice in Wonderland is also a wonderful movie which children you can watch on your televisions. See, Alice in Wonderland. Alice in Wonderland is a fantasy novel. Fantasy means imaginative fiction involving magic and adventures. Means all magic is there, adventures is there in this novel, which is written by Lewis Carroll. It tells us of the adventures of a little girl called Alice, who falls into a rabbit hole and finds herself in a fantasy world where funny people mingle. Mingle means mix with peculiar creatures. Now, creatures means strange living beings, animals, or human. Here, she happens to attend a tea party with three of them. And who are they three? The March Hare, the Mad Hatter, and the Dormouse. So, children, we will see first introduction of Alice, who is the main character of Alice in Wonderland, means a mad tea party. Okay? Alice is a beautiful, modest 19-year-old girl. She is 19-year-old girl and she is modest, means she is very humble, she is very kind. She is the daughter of Charles Kingsley, a wealthy man. Okay, she is the daughter of a very wealthy man. Wealthy means having lot of wealth, money. Alice has been having the same nightmare over and over since her childhood. Now, since her childhood, Alice is having same nightmare every night. Now, students, what do you mean by nightmare? Nightmare means a very bad or frightening dream. And in that nightmare, she sees that she falls down a rabbit hole and encounters means meet various talking animals and an unusual queen. So, see, children, as you can see in the picture, children, this is Alice. She is sitting under the tree and she is very bored. And this is her sister. Okay, her sister, she has promised to play with her. But now her sister, she is busy reading a book. Now, while she wondered what to do, she saw a strange white rabbit run by her. So when Alice was following rabbit, Alice, she falls into a rabbit hole and she enters into a fantasy world. See, children, this is Lewis Carroll, who has written the novel Alice in Wonderland. He was born on 29th January 1832 and he died on 14th January 1898. Now, Lewis Carroll, he was an English novelist as well as he was a poet. And some of the notable works of Lewis Carroll are Alice Adventure in Wonderland, Through the Looking Glass, The Hunting, The Snark. Now, the main theme of this Alice in Wonderland is that of growing up, means to talk something meaningful. Lewis Carroll's book, Alice in Wonderland, it is full of fanciful characters, each one adding a bit of humor and dimension to the story. So children, let's see what are the main characters of the play. First is Alice. Second one is the March Hare. Third one is the Mad Hatter. and the dormouse. Okay, so children, we will start. So children, as you can see in the picture, there is a table which is set out under a tree in front of the house. As you can see, this is Mad Hatter who is wearing the hat. Okay, here Dormouse is there who is busy sleeping, and here March Hare is there, and this one is Alice. Okay, there was a table set out under a tree in front of the house, and the March Hare and the Hatter were having tea at it. Dormouse was sitting between them fast asleep, and the other two were using it as a cushion, resting their elbows on it and talking over its head. Now, as soon as Alice enters into the rabbit hole, children, she enters into a fantasy land where a table is set out under a tree in front of the house, and the March Hare and the Mad Hatter, they were drinking tea at that table. And a dormouse, as you can see, okay, he was sitting between the March Hare and the Hatter. And the dormouse, he is fast asleep, means he is sleeping, okay. And the other two, means the Mad Hatter and the March Hare, they are resting, means they are keeping their elbows on dormouse, okay. And they are using dormouse as a cushion to keep their elbows, and both the March Hare and the Mad Hatter, they are busy talking with each other. Okay, very uncomfortable for the dormouse, thought Alice. Only as it's asleep, I suppose it doesn't mind. Now, seeing this scenario, Alice thought in her mind, it would be very uncomfortable for the dormouse. And why would it be uncomfortable, children? Because both the March Hare and the Mad Hatter, they are resting their elbows on the dormouse. And further, now Alice is thinking that as the dormouse is fast asleep, means he is sleeping, it wouldn't mind keeping their elbows on him. The table was a large one, but the three were all crowded together at one corner of it. No room, no room, they cried out when they saw Alice coming. Okay, now children, the table, it was a very large one, but all these three, the dormouse, the Mad Hatter and the March Hare, they were sitting together at one corner of the table, and the rest of the space of the table was empty. Now, as soon as they were seeing that both the Mad Hatter and the March Hare, because dormouse is fast asleep, okay, when they saw Alice coming towards the table, they cried out, no space, no space, means there is no place for Alice to sit on the table. Now, previously only we have seen that the table, it is very large, and then too they were not allowing Alice to sit on the table. Okay, there's plenty of room, said Alice indignantly. And she sat down in a large armchair at one end of the table. Now, Alice indignantly means showing anger. Alice, she angrily said that there's plenty of room, there is plenty of space on the table. And she, by herself only, she sat down in a large armchair at one end of the table. As you can see, this is one end of the table, and she is sitting on this armchair. Now, have some wine, the March Hare said in an encouraging tone. Now, the March Hare, in an encouraging tone means motivating speech, motivating tone. He is saying to Alice, have some wine. Alice looked all round the table, but there was nothing on it but tea. I don't see any wine, she remarked. Okay. So Alice, she had a look all round the table, but there was no wine on the table. There was only tea. Then Alice commented that I don't see any wine. There isn't any, said the March Hare. Now the March Hare is saying that there is no wine on the table. Then it wasn't very civil of you to offer it, said Alice angrily. Now here the March Hare and the Mad Hatter, they both are troubling Alice. So Alice, she is angrily saying that it wasn't very civil. Now civil means polite, well-mannered. Means, is this your manners? Is this your politeness? When the wine is not available on the table, why you people are offering that wine to me? Okay. It wasn't very civil of you to sit down without being invited, said the March Hare. Now, the March Hare, he is replying to Alice by saying that this is also not your good manners. This is also not your politeness, your good behavior, that without being invited, as she is not invited here in the tea party, she had fell into the rabbit hole and she had come by herself. So the March Hare is saying that without being invited, you sat on the armchair. Okay. Actually, the March Hare and the Mad Hatter, they did not like that without asking or without taking permission, Alice, she has sat on the armchair. I didn't know it was your table, said Alice. It's laid for a great many more than three. Okay, see now what Alice is saying. She is saying that she was not knowing that it was their table. Okay, so if she was knowing that it was Mad Hatter and March Hare's table, she wouldn't have sat. She thought it was a general table on which anyone can sit. And more to it, the table was a very large one. More than three people can comfortably sit on it. Your hair wants cutting, said the Hatter. He had been looking at Alice for some time with great curiosity. And this was his first speech. Now see children, till now the conversation, it was going on between the March Hare and Alice. And we have seen that Dormouse, he is fast asleep, means he is sleeping. Now the Mad Hatter, okay, the one who is wearing hat. Now the Mad Hatter, after observing Alice for some time, means for quite some time, he has been very keenly observing Alice. Now with great curiosity, curiosity means the tendency to ask and learn about things by asking questions. Curiosity means asking questions. Okay, now he is saying that your hair wants cutting, means what, Alice should cut her hairs. And this was his first speech. Okay, you should learn not to make personal remarks, Alice said with some severity. It's very rude. Now Alice said with severity. Severity means seriousness or sternness, that he should learn, he should know not to make any personal remarks, not to give any personal comments. It's very rude. Okay, she was saying that it is very rude to tell such a statement or give such personal remark to Alice. The Hatter opened his eyes very wide on hearing this, but all he said was, why is a raven like a writing desk? Now, the Mad Hatter, as the name suggests, he is little mad, okay? Now, he is opening his eyes very wide on hearing this, okay? What Alice had told just now. Now, what he is saying, you know, why is a raven like a writing desk? Means he's asking something. Okay, now children, here raven means a black crow. And writing desk means the desk on which we write. Now the similarity between both of these is raven and writing desk, both are smooth to touch. Now Hatter is saying, why is a raven like a writing desk? Means he is thinking that why raven and writing desk both are similar. Okay, now children, I'll tell you some differences between raven and a writing desk. Raven is a black crow. Okay, see, raven, it is having life, it is having voice, it has a beak, it is having feathers, it has feelings, and it can also fly. Okay, but writing desk, as we all know, it is a non-living thing. It doesn't have any life. It is made up of wood. It doesn't have any voice. Okay, no beak, no feathers, no feelings. Okay, it cannot move also. It is fixed at one place. So these were some differences between the raven and the writing desk. Only the similarity is that raven and writing desk both are smooth to touch. Okay, come, we shall have some fun now, thought Alice. Now Alice is saying to Mad Hatter, come on now, we will have some fun. I am glad they have begun asking riddles. I believe I can guess that, she added aloud. Okay, now she said that she is happy that at least they have begun asking riddles. Riddles means puzzles. Okay, so she was happy that now at least they will not argue or give comments on her. Alice said that she believed that she can guess the riddle, means she was trying to guess the answer of the riddle. And what was that riddle? Why is a raven like a writing desk? Do you mean that you think you can find out the answer of it? Said the March Hare. Now the March Hare is saying that he is asking that do you mean that you can find out the answer to the riddle that I have asked? Okay. So, exactly so, said Alice. Okay, Alice is saying that exactly, of course, means I can guess the riddle. Then you should say what you mean, the March Hare went on. Okay, I do, Alice hastily replied. Hastily means quickly. At least I mean what I say. That's the same thing you know. Okay, now here, one conversation is going on. Here the March Hare is saying that what you say, that what you mean, means what you are saying that you should mean it. Okay. So Alice is quickly replying that at least what I mean, I say that only. Okay. Now here the Hatter is saying not the same thing a bit. Now here Hatter is saying that I say what I mean and I mean what I say, it's not the same thing. Actually, it's both different. Okay. So here Hatter is saying that I say what I mean and I mean what I say, both are different statements. Now children, see, I say what I mean and why I mean what I say. Actually, it is an advice given in a sentence. Means say what you mean and mean what you say. See, in first part, I say what I mean. It is advised not to talk foolish or stupid or to talk about actually which is real. And it is a reflection of your heart and you should mean it. Don't tell something like mumbo jumbo talks. Always speak which you are supposed to do or believe in. Okay. And in the second part, I say what I mean. Okay. In that, I mean what I say, it is an advice of following your words is given. It is made clear for you to do as it is to you make any commitment. Don't even deny your given statement. Means you should not deny your given statement. Always do the work which you have talked about. Means always think before you talk and whatever you say, you should perform it. Now see, here the Hatter again is saying, you might just as well say that I see what I eat is the same thing as I eat what I see. Now Hatter is saying that you will say that I see what I eat and I eat what I see. You will say these are also both similar. But children, here both the sentences, again they are different. Okay, both are having completely different meaning. Now see, I see what I eat. Here the verb is see. And I eat what I see, your verb is eat. Means both the sentences are different. Because the main action in each sentence, it is completely different. I see what I eat means I understand what I eat and I am aware of the consequences. And I eat what I see, it means the one who does not care about eating habits. You might just as well say, you might just as well say, added the March Hare, that I like what I get is the same thing as I get what I like. Now the March Hare is saying that you will say I like what I get and I get what I like is also the same thing. Okay, now further March Hare is saying you will also that say that I like what I get is the same thing as I get what I like. Now here also students, the meaning is totally different. I like what I get means whatever things I get, I like it. And I get what I like means whatever things I like, I get that only. Okay. You might just as well say, added the dormouse who seemed to be talking in his sleep. Now, this is his first conversation after a long time. We have seen that dormouse, he was fast asleep. Now, he is saying that in his sleep only he is talking. And he is saying that I breathe when I sleep is the same thing as I sleep when I breathe. Now, here dormouse is saying that you will say that I breathe when I sleep. And I sleep when I breathe. It is also the same thing. Now, children, here also the meanings are totally different. Okay. I breathe when I sleep means whenever I am sleeping, I breathe. Okay. And I sleep when I breathe means whenever I am breathing, I am sleeping. So, here also the meanings are totally different. Okay. It's the same thing with you, said the Hatter. And here the conversation dropped. And here the conversation has stopped and the party sat silent for a minute. Okay, for 60 seconds the party has gone very silent. All were silent for a minute. While Alice thought over all she could remember about Raven's and writing desk, which wasn't much. Now when this all conversation has stopped, now Alice, she was trying to remember about Raven's and writing desk riddle. And what was that riddle? Why is a raven like a writing desk? Now, have you guessed the riddle yet? The Hatter said, turning to Alice again. Okay, now Hatter, he is asking Alice that have you got the answer to your riddle? Okay, no, I give it up, Alice replied. What's the answer? I haven't the slightest idea, said the Hatter. Nor I, said the March Hare. Okay, now Alice is saying that no, I give it up means I don't know the answer. Okay. Alice has asked the answer to the riddle. Okay. She told that I am not knowing answer to your riddle. Okay. Now Alice is asking, so what is the answer to the riddle? Now Hatter is saying that I haven't the slightest idea. Means I also don't know the answer. I am not having even idea also key what will be the answer of that riddle. Nor I, said the March Hare. A March Hare is also saying that I am also not knowing the answer of the riddle. Okay. They were just doing time pass with Alice. Alice sighed wearily. I think you might do something better with the time, she said, then waste it in asking riddles that have no answer. Now, Alice, she was very tired. Okay. She said tiredly. Wearily means tiredly. She said that I think we can make better use of time. So, why waste time in asking riddles which are not having answers? So this was the suggestion given by Alice to the Mad Hatter, the March Hare and the Dormouse. Okay. So children, we will see the meanings. Fantasy, imaginative fiction involving magic and adventure. Mingle means mix. Peculiar means strange. Creatures means a living being, an animal or a human. Indigently means showing anger that has been caused by something wrong, unjust or mean. Encourage means to motivate. Civil means polite, well-mannered. Remark, an act of pointing out or noticing, notice or observation. Curiosity, the tendency to ask and learn about things by asking questions, investigating or exploring. Next, severity, it means sternness, seriousness. Riddles means a verbal puzzle or mystery. Hastily means quickly, hurriedly. Okay, now children, I am going to ask you questions on which on the part of Mad Party which I have taught to you. You have to choose the correct options. So children, now you can unmute yourself. And my first question is, which of these characters are not there in a Mad Tea Party? Your options are, first, the Dormouse, second, the March Hare, third, Rupa Bai, fourth, the Mad Hatter.
Which Rupa of this, Bai.
यस वेरी गुड रूपा भाई, शी इज नॉट अ कैरेक्टर इन अ मैड टी पार्टी. माय नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज नेम द ऑथर ऑफ द नॉवेल एलिस इन वंडरलैंड एंड योर ऑप्शंस आर ई नेस्बिथ, सेकंड विलियम शेक्सपियर, थर्ड लुइस कैरल, फोर्थ जॉर्ज कूपर. व्हाट विल बी द राइट आंसर? हु इज द ऑथर ऑफ द नॉवेल ऑफ एलिस इन वंडरलैंड? Your options are
Lewis Carroll.
Yes, Lewis Carroll. Excellent answer. Very good. My next question is, have some wine. Who said this statement to Alice? And your options are the Dormouse, the Mad Hatter, the March Hare, Lewis Carroll. Who said this statement to Alice? That have some
the
wine.
March Hare.
Very good. The March Hare. He said, have some wine. Okay. My next question is, your hair wants cutting. Who said this statement to Alice? And your options are the Dormouse, the Mad Hatter, the March Hare, Lewis Carroll. Who said your hair wants cutting?
The Mad Hatter.
Yes, excellent answer. The Mad Hatter. Very good. Okay, children, now give opposites of come. What will be the opposite of come?
Go.
Go. Very good. Nothing.
Something.
Nothing. Nothing. Any more answers from any other student?
Everything.
Nothing. Yes. Very good. Everything. Okay. First.
Last.
Very good. Here.
There.
Very good. Same.
Different.
Yes. Very good. Very good. Excellent answers. Next. Like.
Dislike.
Very good. Answer.
Question.
Okay. Very good. Wise. Wise. What will be the opposite of wise? Okay, no guesses. Should I say the answer? Okay, the opposite of wise is foolish. Okay? Okay, next. Strong.
Weak.
Weak. Very good. Kind.
Unkind.
Unkind. Very good. Allow.
Deny.
Unallow.
Allow.
Deny.
Okay, deny.
Deny.
Yeah, deny. It is deny. D-E-N-Y. Deny. It's right answer. And disallow will also come. Very good. Okay, children. Now I'm going to say you some riddles. Okay. First riddle is, I have branches, but no fruits, trunk or leaves. What am I? So children, I have branches, but no fruit, trunk or leaves. What am I? And your answer is a bank. See, bank, it is having branches, but it is not having any fruit, trunk or leaves. Okay. My next riddle is, I am tall when I am young and I am short when I am old. Okay. So who am I? So I am tall when I am young. When he is young, he is tall. And when he is short, he is old. So who am I? It is a candle. See children, candle, when it is tall, it is young. And when it is short, it is old. Okay. My next riddle for you is, I have many teeth, but I can't bite. I am often used early morning, but rarely at night. Who am I? Okay, your answer is comb. See, comb, it is having many teeth, but it can't bite. And mostly comb we use early morning. Okay, my next riddle. I follow you all the time and copy your every move, but you can't touch me or catch me. Who am I? So your answer will be your shadow. Okay, see, shadow, it follows us all the time. Okay, and it also copies our every move, but we cannot touch our shadow or we cannot catch our shadow. Okay, next riddle. People buy me to eat, but never eat me. What am I? Okay, so your answer will be plates and cutlery. Okay, we buy it for eating, but we never eat plates and cutlery. Okay, okay, last riddle for you is, I have lakes with no water, mountains with no stone and cities with no buildings. What am I? Okay, and your answer is map. See, in map we have the symbols of lakes, mountains and cities. Okay, but actually there is no water. Okay, actually there are no stones, there is no buildings, only the symbols are there. So your answer here is a map. Okay children, the next part of Mad Tea Party we will see in our next lecture of English. Thank you very much for your cooperation. Thank you children.
Thank you, ma'am.